Welcome back. We will start to try to do this. Yeah, keep weakening them up, man. We know they have that army there. Kinda hate to have to capture a place for a scare, but we'll get her done. We'll take these guys, blade ones, mortals could be good, anti-vehicle. So we'll let him just keep attacking here. He really has no good honor guard units. None of these guys do. I don't understand why it's like it chooses two armies that get a bunch of honor guard units and everybody else doesn't, and they're just weak. I don't get it. I don't get this at all. So it's a single base, so we'll just slowly try to accumulate resources here. Get our requisition saved up when we take out the Dark Eldar. I'm not sure which one I want to use for the final stronghold. I imagine it's probably going to be the Tower of the Orcs. Guess we'll all see how that plays out. Taking a long time to load. Any time now. Put you here. Then you here. You guys out there. Shoe building. Keep the army's moving forward. You're now done, so you can start building. Those farming. You can assist there. We're looking at that. We'll get you guys up here.
Rejoice in the coming of Lavia!
Phase shifter. So taking out this here. Just pulling you back after soaking up those attacks. So that's the one thing these guys are good at is we can get the turrets to focus on them. And then you can phase shift them and they'll still try to attack them while they're phase shifted. Fairly quick. In fact, I think it probably took just about as much time to load and get things going as it did to do the level. So hopefully this will continue to be how it goes as we march across kaurava 4. So 4 should be a single base as well. Now it's probably going to have some turrets. I kinda wish they would attack this spot here.
Fall back.
So then the orcs wouldn't have that, because that is a difficult mission to take from the orcs. Why is this showing up? Oh, because it's for the enemy, not that we will have broken supply lines. I was gonna say, I don't think we should have that. Given that we've already taken out the chaos, and chaos by definition has the ability to be able to hold places without having broken supply lines. I don't know, I preferred the Dark Crusade over the Soulstorm one. I find this one to be a little bit frustrating with the way they rolled things out in terms of, you know, having to take out certain strongholds and things first. If you're just, you know, playing the game and don't want to try to experience things like, oh, this one's gonna be, you know, want to try each race with the different difficulties, because, you know, later on when you play with them later on, then the strongholds themselves can be a little more difficult as the enemy becomes stronger as you progress throughout the game. You know, I'd like to see each place for how difficult it is, you know, and the Dark Crusade, you know, they'd have bigger rushes for you and things. They try to, seems like they're pushing a little bit away from that on this game. The defensive missions, you know, you got to have whatever base you had before, so they decided they wanted to go against that, and I guess I understand that, because you could easily abuse it, and then when you capture a place that would be attacked frequently, you could, I can't imagine their bases here. Oh, it's down here. You could abuse it and then just capture everything, and then they can fight a battle right as soon as they land. But at the same time, it would make sense that you would be able to fortify it once you captured it. But maybe that's just me. But, you know, not being able to build a forward base and stuff until you take over a race that has that ability, I don't know. I find that just to be kind of annoying, because we fight our way across these areas. And I'd kind of like to have the forward base ability without having to take out different races and things like that. Really? Oh, of course I gotta fight it because I didn't save it. Eldar. We're supposed to be going for the other units. Other races' location. Not taking out my location. Worst thing is he could rush me, and that could be very problematic. because my units are so slow to build in the beginning. Good thing is there's only one of them, one base instead of two. Seems like the Necron Lord's being built at a reasonable pace. This is what I was worried about. Well, that was a rough start.
Victory countdown has begun.
Damn. No, and I bet the scarab they destroyed was,
Six minutes until taken hold victory.
Alright, so we'll have you go over here. Done there. We'll let them start to catch up. Start moving you up. This is the one moving soon. Army over, I'm guessing. I killed the hero. Upgraded. Have that going next. Hopefully no anti-vehicle. They're just going vehicle crazy, like they know I don't have anti-vehicle. Good news is...
Gone.
so I should probably go with those guys then. Since they are going so vehicle heavy.
Six minutes until taken hold victory.
Oh, this is what was doing damage to me. It's like, why did their damage increase so sudden?
4 minutes until taken hold victory. Until taken, hold victory.
Crap. Got an army around here somewhere, I'm just not sure where. Down here. Maybe I shouldn't say army at base.
1 minute until taking hold victory.
There it is. Well, I guess the Dark Elder are going to play this way. I got to start reinforces all my webway gates. It's a little bit annoying. I don't know. Wow. Melee kind of sucks, but his range attack goes up pretty exponentially. I guess I'm going with that then. Alright, so let's reinforce. So let's attack there. Thank you. seen film in the mountain of turrets yet. Hopefully they're behaving themselves with that. Minutes 18 seconds. Pretty good. Now, I will say, I was expecting to be a little bit farther than this. I was not expecting the Dark Elva to attack. It was kind of unusual. There's a tech in there, that's different.
The Khadra will crush them. In Tau, I am strong. Let's get out of here.
Now. I have enough to afford everything. Maybe not everything. Yeah. Okay. Let's attack here as well, I guess. I think this will be the last mission then for this video. But that way we'll be all prepared for taking out the Dark Eldar on the next one. And then we can go up and take out couple of those webway gates and make planet fall on Kaurava 2. I think they're across. I think I'm just going to run over there just to verify that this is in fact where his army is, but I'm almost positive it is. Yep, it is. All right, get out of there. Crap. players were. Alright, that wasn't too bad. Alright, save it. Don't want to get sucked into these super super long videos. I mean, that Chaos Fortress one I think was almost 2 hours, so no, I don't think we're gonna run into issues. It seems like the forces for Chaos were just exceptionally well made to counter. Our Necron forces here. Because the plasmagons and everybody was concealed or infiltrated, I guess is what they call it in this game. And therefore, none of my units could see them. Thank you. so I don't perceive him quite as well, but that's where I was going with that. Alright, that one was much better than the 18-minute one before. I expected that to be the case. And the question is, do I have enough?
We must withdraw. Oh.
Good. Don't do that. I want you attacking strongholds. Alright, good. So we can definitely attack the Dark Elder next time. Go over here. It looks like we'll have to make Planet Ball here. And then the decision will have to be made. Where to go from here, and whether the stupid Tau keep attacking these guys. If they do, they'll have to go boom, boom, up here as fast as I can so they don't accidentally take out this guy's army. I don't think they're going to be able to with only that amount of honor guard, but you don't want to lose out on that, so. Okay. We'll call it quits here for the day. Thank you for watching, and continue to upload videos daily. If you're enjoying my videos, please give my channel a like and subscribe to encourage me to post more for you. Have a great day.